we don't attach any significance to thought, because thought is recycling of the data that we have already gathered. No thought can come which is absolutely fresh. Permutations and combinations of the data that we already have. Right now, a lot of people coming up to me very fearfully and saying, "Sadhguru, this artificial intelligence is coming. If they come, they will take over the world." I said, "If they take over and run the damn thing, you're on a holiday, isn't it?" But it is a fact that everything that we can gather as information, analyze and express and use it in many ways, all these things, machines will be doing it better than us in the next 10 to 15 years' time. Everything that is data-based processing, machines will do way better than us. So there is this fear. I think it's a very good time. This is the time we need to explore an intelligence beyond intellect. Because we have become so intellectual, we have become so brain-oriented in our approach to everything. As you rightly said, nothing is really turned off, we've just broken the communication. After all, the purpose is to go through something which is generally extremely painful without pain. That is how the entire anesthetic sciences come up. So you're just breaking the communication, and that's not happening, it serves that purpose. So being wakeful and being conscious are two different things. If we… Is it okay if I take a few minutes? This is described like this. For wakefulness, we have a word called jagriti. Jagriti means you're awake. If 10 people, let's say we take sample of 10 people, they all fell asleep, don't do it, okay? They all fell asleep and they came awake. When they come awake, all of them will not be equally awake. One person may be instantly awake, another person may take 2 minutes, as you have noticed with anesthesia also.
Sure.
Another person will take an hour to wake up, another person needs a strong coffee, otherwise she won't wake up. Am I right? Like this, different levels of wakefulness is also there. Professors must have noticed.
Yes, yes. In fact, the first few minutes of the day can be like that.
Different levels of wakefulness in a classroom. So this is jagriti. So we are calling wakefulness as consciousness. Now, the next dimension of consciousness is called swapna. This means a dream state. A dream state is far more vivid than wakeful state for most human beings. It's like going to a cinema. If you go to a cinema, the key factor of the impact of the cinema on you is turning off the lights. This is something most people don't understand. If you don't turn off the lights, cinema will be no good, it doesn't matter how well it's made. Turn on the lights and watch the cinema, you will see a great cinema becomes nothing. So turning off the lights is important. So turning off the lights in our experiences, the eyelids, you down the shutters, the world is off. Now you start your own world. So dream state is like a cinema, it's far more impactful. People love their cinema stars more than the people that they've lived with for 25 years. But they have not even seen them, all they saw was play of light and sound. Mm-hmm. But that is far more impactful simply because lights are off. Mm-hmm. So, eyelid is that, if you roll it down, light should be off, world should be closed. But right now, the problem is this mental faculty has not been taken charge of, so it's running wild all the time with eyes closed. So this dream state is considered a more powerful state than jagriti. Jagriti or wakefulness is important for performing action in the world. But for human consciousness, in terms of profoundness of experience, dream is always more profound than walking on the street. Yes, most of you have experienced this. The next state is called a susupti. Susupti means it is a dreamless state. But there are dimensions of consciousness that you're aware of. Mm-hmm. It's a totally dreamless sleep state, but you're aware. There is no picturization, there is no video running in your mind, there's no pictures, there are no people, there are no words, but you're conscious in your sleep. This is a very powerful state. If you really want to manifest something in your life, this is something to be explored. And the next one is called as Turiya. This is consciousness, where there is no memory involved of any kind. Essentially in the yogic sciences, we are looking at consciousness as an intelligence beyond memory. Mm-hmm. If there is memory, memory is considered a boundary in a sense. This is one person, this is another person, simply because this embodies one kind of memory and that embodies another kind of memory. This has become one kind of person, this has become another kind of person. Essentially, it is in the memory. Memory does not mean just what I remember and you remember. Genetic memory is there, evolutionary memory is there, elemental memory is there, atomic memory is there, karmic memory is there. Inarticulate and articulate memories are there, but generally we are thinking memory means consciously what we can remember. Mm-hmm. But today, if we eat dog food, we'll not become dogs. Something within us remembers, no matter what you eat, this has to be only transformed into a human being. Mm-hmm. It doesn't matter what you eat. If you and a cow every day eat a mango, no merger will happen. Perfect memory is established, evolutionary memory is absolute. Mm-hmm. So, these different dimensions of memory are playing on a daily basis. People are thinking their thoughts are free. It's a joke because your memory is determining everything. So, largely in one single word we call this karma. Karma means the residual impact of all the memory that you have, how it is impacting every thought, every emotion, every action, the very way you sit and stand. Mm-hmm. See, if you see somebody walking far away, let's say half a mile away you see someone walking, if he's your friend, just the way they're moving their body, you say, oh, that's him. There are 7 billion plus people, but this particular man walks in a unique way, mm-hmm. All right? Just do like walking, everybody walks, but still it is so unique. So this is what we are referring to as karma, that the residual impact of memory, varieties of memory, we recognize memory as 8 basic forms of memory, which are determining how you are right now. The very way you sit, stand, breathe, understand, perceive life is determined by this memory. But there is an intelligence beyond memory, which we call as Turiya or Chitta. This is consciousness. Now, every one of us is conscious. The question is only of degree. Even a rock is conscious, a dog is conscious, a pig is conscious. The question is only of degree, how conscious. Even among us, how conscious is different from person to person. So, this degree of consciousness determines everything. Now, if we have to give an analogy, what is memory is like, I'm sure every one of us at some stage in our life, I don't know if you're still doing it, we blew soap bubbles, did you? Hello? Oh, come on, everybody raised their hand for anesthesia, did you? So, when you blow a soap bubble, the soap part of it, which is very little, just a tiny drop, the large part of it is air that it captures. So how big a bubble? When you were children, who can blow the biggest bubble was a big deal. Mm. And it's a certain amount of technique.
Yes.
How you do it. Somebody blew this big bubble, somebody got only this much. So how big a bubble? This bubble is like this. The kind of soap and how it gathers is your memory. It forms a… it gives it a form. But when the memory bursts, there is no such thing as your air and my air. There is no such thing as your consciousness and my consciousness. There is something called as your body and my body. There is something called as your memory and my memory. There is something called as your intellect and my intellect. But there is nothing called as your consciousness and my consciousness. How much of it did you capture? How big is your bubble? Will determine the scale of your life. Mm-hmm. the scale and possibilities of your life are determined by how big a bubble did you blow.
Okay.